Hey, what is going on, guys? Welcome back to the show. Welcome back to Pure Wrestling here live. We're here to put on a great show for you today. Let's see, this is the go-home show to now the pay-per-view we now know as the Great American Bash. July 4th is coming up soon, but right now we're here in Santa Clara, California. I would like to thank everybody for their support for this show, these shows lately, and thank you to whoever likes, comments, and also shares this video. Thank you so much. But now we're going to go into the card. We have a triple threat match. We have one former contender for the Women's Wrestling Champion, and that is Natalya going up against Naomi and Tamina. This is the opening contest. Hopefully it's going to be an interesting one. As next, we have TJ Perkins making a little return here against the man that took him out, which is Baron Corbin. We all know what happened backstage. Baron Corbin, what he did to him, and now he's back. And then we have Dana Brooke. She's going to take on a mystery opponent. And this mystery opponent, according to Shane McMahon and Vince McMahon, is the number one contender for the Women's Wrestling Championship at the Great American Bash. We all know Dana Brooke is also missing Money in the Bank, so let's see how this transpires through the night. Then we have a tag team action going on. Number one contenders match, Breeze Angle versus the Young Bucks. It can go either way. I mean, the Office of Pain is a very tough tag team to defeat later when it comes to the pay-per-views, but let's see which team has what it takes to become number one contender. And we already hear the villain Marty Skrull and Finn Balor are going to face off yet again here tonight. Marty Skrull in his second main event in a row in Pure Wrestling. Now he's going to defeat Finn Balor once again. But this time, Kenny Omega is excluded from action. He is banned from ringside. And the Young Bucks are, of course, having a match. So that leaves Marty Skrull without any outside interference against Finn Balor. Let's see if the Demon King can get a win. As Natalya defeats Tamina and Naomi, showing that she does still deserve that number one contendership status. TJ Perkins defeated a former champion, former two-time champion, in Baron Corbin. My, that is a huge, huge upset. As we set up for Dana Brooke versus this mystery opponent. As you could see, Finn Balor gearing up for his matchup later on tonight. He heard management gave him a second opportunity, a second chance against Marty Skrull here tonight with no interference. So let's see what's going to happen. But he's heading into the office of Vince McMahon. And he's going to talk to Vince for a little bit. Let's see what he's got to say. Well, Vince, you know that me and Kenny Omega have been at each other's throats since season one. You know that this match is very important to me. I want him more than ever at our next pay-per-view. I need that contender shot. He robbed me of my briefcase. That title is supposed to be mine. Everyone knows it. You know it. I just need that next opportunity. This will be our fifth encounter. And trust me, hopefully it'll be our last. Well, Finn, fifth encounter. If I give you this opportunity, you better not lose. This opportunity hasn't been given to another person, another individual, another wrestler besides you. You faced the Royal Rumble, but before that you faced them at last year's Money in the Bank. And then after that, you faced him in Pure Wrestling twice for the briefcase. Now this is the fifth encounter, the Great American Bash. And you know what? I'll accept it. We're having a lot of star-studded matches, and your match will be one of them. You and Omega will face off for the Great American Bash for that Pure Wrestling Championship. Of course, later on tonight, you'll have a match with Marty Skrull with no interference, no Kenny Omega, no Young Bucks. and let's just see how you do. Well, alright guys, you hear it there. Finn Balor is all ready, he's geared up, and you see he's gonna be walking down that ramp very soon. Of course, with some women's action. Here comes Dana Brooke. And Miss Money in the Bank. People have been saying, I don't know if she hasn't been a top tier contender as of late, and it's seemingly not going to happen that she might cash in, but being really, really patient, and you have to be supportive of the fact that Dana Brooke is really waiting for the right opportunity to cash in on Ember Moon. Let's not forget, Ember Moon is... Ember Moon is a very, very tough competitor, and if you catch her off guard, I'm pretty sure you might win that championship. Of course, Dana Brooke has stated before, she doesn't care how long she holds the briefcase, she will cash in very, very soon. And her opponent is none other than Bea Priestley. An incredible talent around the world. Ladies and gentlemen, what a night. Bea Priestley is in Pure Wrestling and is now known as the number one contender, handpicked by Shane and Vince McMahon. Holy, I cannot wait to see this match. They're gonna have to ring the bell right away. Bea Priestley, it's a sight to see, ladies and gentlemen. It's nice to see her in Pure Wrestling. And Dana Brooke looking right in her eyes. Bea Priestley having her first match here in Pure Wrestling. Here we go. Both of them going at it now. Both women. As referee is gonna call a break there. Clean break, yes, clean break by both women. And now Bea Priestley, oh my god, face first goes Dana Brooke, and already going into the cover. Referee has to count. Oh, the mind games. See, this is why the inclusion of Bea Priestley mixes up the women's division here. Finally, another new face to the division. Oh, big clothesline to the outside, sending Dana Brooke spilling. Oh, big jawbreaker, Dana Brooke. Oh, what a big forearm shot leaves her grounded on the floor. Oh, and right to the barricades. Now everybody's on their feet, checking on what's going on here right in front of them. As Dana Brooke sends her head straight back into the canvas. These two women, of course, their goal is to destroy Ember Moon, but right now they're destroying each other because they're in each other's way. And it's Bea Priestley's taunting right in front of this Santa Clara crowd. It's time to get back in the ring. Oh my goodness. Bea Priestley says, not yet. She picks Dana Brooke up. And then she goes back in the ring. Wow, what a close count that was. Referee had no choice but to count, but look at this. Oh, the knee right to the back. Bea Priestley, she's in full control here. Toss her into the corner now. Oh, picks her up. What's gonna happen now? Hold on, going to the top. Oh my goodness, what is this? I think we're gonna see a butterfly suplex. Oh my god. The back of Dana Brooke has gotta be killing her. And now cover. Wow, I thought she was gonna put her away right there. I'll take my hand. Oh, and Dana Brooke fighting back there. Dana Brooke now, oh no! Bea Priestley capitalized. Now going for maneuver, no. It's a shot right to the rib. And Dana Brooke, no, this time it's her flying around again. Bea Priestley awaiting her moment to strike. Picking her up. Oh! Nice counters, nice defensive tactics from the both ladies here. Oh, slamming her right down. Hold on, Bea Priestley. She's going to finish Dana Brooke off, and we know what's coming. No, oh, wait, Dana Brooke, what? A reversal from Dana, and now Dana Brooke has got her up top, slams her down, and just stretches her out. Will we see a cover? Here it is, cover. One, no, not even a two count. I am shocked. Not even a two count. Dana Brooke is kind of startled, but she's calling her up. Knocking her back down. Now just waiting, turn around. Bea Priestley, oh no, look at this. Oh, there she goes, hard knockdown. Dana Brooke missed Money in the Bank. Gonna top the number one contender. No, a kick out from Priestley. And now pushes her into the corner. Oh, a reversal by Dana Brooke yet again. We know that patented meat strike from Bea Priestley is gonna come out soon. Of course, her finisher is the rolling cutter. We're gonna see that, I'm pretty sure, very soon. Dana Brooke picking her up. No, nice reversal by Bea Priestley. The agility. Priestley's got it all. Here we go, cover. Referee has to count. One, two, no. I mean, she was looking to catch her off guard there, but it was a good try, but it didn't work. As Priestley gonna try something else now. Looking to go up to the top. Oh, big elbow smash right there. And now taunting to the crowd. Not the wisest thing to do during the middle of a match, but oh, big right hand. Oh, big chop, but she missed the chop. Oh, Bea Priestley getting out of it. Now shoves Dana Brooke in the corner. Hold on. Hold, wait a second. Don't tell me she's gonna go through the... Oh my God. Baseball kick. Bea Priestley has just hit a home run here in Pure Wrestling in her debut match. It's over. One, two, what? I thought you could have counted to 100. She wasn't gonna get up. What a match, my goodness. The opening contest. Oh, big right hand. No, Dana Brooke blocks it yet again. I don't know how she's doing it, how she's getting the fight here. But hold on now. Oh, Priestley's down again. Will it be a one count again? We'll just see. Here we go. Oh, a big kick. Not even going for the cover. Dana Brooke now taking her time to taunt. As Dana Brooke taunting her way, Bea Priestley is in grave danger. Here we go. Finish time. Wait a minute. Bea Priestley now. Oh my goodness. Hold on. Oh, the rolling cutter. The rolling cutter just saved her from her vicious finishing maneuver. And now Bea Priestley has just won in her debut match. Ladies and gentlemen, what a woman. This is exactly what I'm talking about when I'm talking about Bea Priestley. The aggressiveness, the ruthless aggression that she has, that she delivers in her matchups. You know what? Now I know why they named her the number one contender. Now the world knows why she is going to face Ember Moon. She just defeated Miss Money in the Bank. What an impressive match. Ladies and gentlemen, the opening contest for Pure Wrestling, I've got to say, What a phenomenal start. And it's only going to get better. Congratulations to Bea Priestley in her first ever match for Pure Wrestling. One has to assume that the tag team championships, the Federation Tag Team Championships, are very important to these men right here. They had a championship title shot, and then they lost. But now, they're trying to regain their status as number one contender to face the Authors of Pain. They must beat the Young Bucks here tonight. And here come the Young Bucks as Breezango made their way into the ring. The Young Bucks are all set and ready. Guess you never know where they are. And here they come. Nick Jackson. Matt Jackson. No Marty Skrull on their side. No Kenny Omega to be found. They want these matches fair. They're gonna get it fair here tonight. Maybe the Bullet Club taking on Breezango, number one contenders match. Whoever wins this goes on to face the Authors of Pain at our next pay-per-view, the Great American Bash. Here we go, Fandango dancing around the ring. Oh my goodness, look at this. Nick Jackson already taking it to Fandango with the submission hold. But Fandango first escapes out of it. I never thought I'd see Fandango reemerge in universe mode, but here he is. And a big knee drop there. Right, hold on, where's he going? Up top, or this early. Fandango calling Nick Jackson up. Oh, but he miscalculated. Oh my goodness. Oh, but a punch. Oh, a punch has got him the upper hand. Big elbow drop from Fandango. Oh, right to the back, and now Fandango just measuring up his opponent. Oh, hold on now, Nick Jackson. Oh my goodness, did you see that? And here we go. Tag is made. Matt Jackson, now the legal man in the ring. A big forearm shot there. Irish whip to the ropes. Oh, and a big arm drag into a neck breaker. I like that maneuver. Very fancy from the Young Bucks, but Breezango, they have to get back into this one. Oh, going for that arm. Come on, Tyler Breeze. Fandango, do something. Here we go. Cover. Kick out. Kick out. Come on. Yes. Okay, a kick out by Breezango. And a big head scissors by the man himself, Fandango. Fandango, I think he should make a tag and be smart enough. Oh, nice reversal. Hold on. Oh, my goodness. Fandango with a big DDT. I didn't think he was going to come with that one all, but he missed a signature chance there. Oh, and a big spear by the Young Bucks. You know the Young Bucks like to make fun of everybody. Trying to kick him down. Oh, goodness. go. Oh, but come on, Fandango, help out your tag team partner. Come on, oh, there we go. Tyler Breeze getting that momentum there. Amazing maneuver by Tyler Breeze now. Breeze getting the upper hand, working together as a team. Yeah, just stay over there, Nick Jackson. You stay on the ropes there. While Matt Jackson gets pummeled by Breezango here. Oh, and a big knee strike there. Hold on. Oh, and Zaguri. These two teams have faced before, but never showcased like this. Oh. Uh-oh, here we go. A super kick, the beginning. The first super kick of the night. Super kick right to Tyler Breeze. Here we go. Cover. One, two, and Breezango with the kick out. And a tag made to Nick Jackson. Nick Jackson now trying to go for the cover. No. Yeah, he was trying to probably take him off guard there. Trying to knock off Breezango for this match. Again, wrenching the arm and driving his shoulder right into the mat. Works very nice, and a supermodel kick right by Tyler Breeze from out of nowhere. And this match has just picked up for Breezango. Oh no, he missed a beauty shot. Beauty shot missed. Here we go. Oh, he was going to go for a maneuver, taking off the same man that made the spear famous, Edge. But, oh no, another super kick to Tyler Breeze. Super kick to Tyler Breeze. That's not good. Uh-oh. The Young Bucks could possibly win it here. Breezango in trouble. And a kick out from Breeze. Second super kick. Breeze kicks out of it. Hold on, running DDT. He caught him. Tyler Breeze now looking to make the tag with Fandango. Wise choice there as Tyler Breeze took already two super kicks of the match. Oh, look at that. Oh, I thought he was going to go for the cover. And Tyler Breeze is feeling it there in the corner. Big shoulder tackle by Fandango. Fandango looking to bring him to the middle. Cover. One. No, not even a two count. No, oh, going for a cutter there, but no. Fandango was going for something special there. I couldn't tell right there. I knew it was coming. Oh wait, hold on. This time Fandango countering Nick Jackson. Nick Jackson is now busted open. Picks him up slowly. Here we go. A schoolboy cover. Nice by Fandango. Two. Oh, he almost got him. Almost became number one contenders, and smart Nick Jackson rolling out the ring, but not so wise coming back in that soon. I would have taken a little breather before coming in, or else this is going to happen. Or else Fandango will pick the pieces, pick apart his opponent. But oh my god! Oh my god, look who it is! It's Luke Gallows and Carl Anderson! The Balor Club, or whatever you want to call them, they're here! We haven't seen these men ever since they got drafted, the Young Bucks! They look like they've seen a ghost, ladies and gentlemen! A fresh new tag team! Wait, watch out, look in the ring! Here we go, Northern Lights! Oh, I thought he was gonna go for the cover. Oh, but wait! Fandango sizing him up, looking for that signature leg drop. He hits it on Nick Jackson. The crowd is going crazy as he goes for the cover. One, two. I cannot believe it. I'm at a loss for words, ladies and gentlemen. That is it. The distraction by the debuting Carl Anderson and Luke Gallows. what a night it's been. The new number one contenders and a new debuting tag team in Gallows and Anderson. Ladies and gentlemen, you have to assume that is work from Finn Balor himself. That is revenge from last week because of him and Marty Scurll. Now they're going to collide yet again for the night. Well, here comes Cesaro. Let's see. He has a few things to say after being number one contender for the nation's championship for the Great American Bash. Maybe an announcement is going to be made here today. Ladies and gentlemen, when I fight for the right to become nation's champion, I'm going to do it for my fallen partner, Tyson Kidd. I'm going to do it for this show, for this brand, and more importantly, for the guys in the back that always believed in me. I would like to thank all of you as well. The reason why I'm here standing today is because of the fight that I've been showing, because of the support that you have been giving me throughout the years. I'd like to take a moment and say that Nation's Championship, when I went up to Vince McMahon and Shane McMahon, when I shook their hand and became that number one contender, they told me that I can spice up the pay-per-view a little bit for all of you guys. They said I can pick a stipulation, but the stipulation that I chose has something to do with my career. And that's because everybody has been telling me, oh, Cesaro, you haven't been climbing the brass ring. Even Vince McMahon himself has said in the back that I haven't climbed the brass ring far enough, that I haven't done it. I haven't been at my peak. But you know what? On Sunday, I'm gonna prove that I will climb that brass ring, and I will climb that ladder, and I will retrieve the nation's championship. That's right, it is going to be a ladder match for the nation's championship. And in all due respect, Roderick Strong, we're in this ring. There's a difference. We're in this ring, or we're in the back. All these people want a show, and we're going to give them to it. Me and you, we're going to fight for that championship. It's time for the main event. Pure Wrestling has never seen anything, anybody, anyone like the villain himself, Marty Scurll. Him and the Demon King collided. He ended up winning because of interference. But now there's nobody on his side. Now it's just him and Finn Balor. Let's see if Marty Scurll has what it takes to beat Finn Balor clean one-on-one here tonight. Let's see how he does as the universe here has been buzzing, of course, buzzing about the latest superstar returning at a Great American Bash for one more match of his choosing. Anybody, it can be anybody in the CJN or Pure Wrestling locker room. That man is the Olympic gold medalist, Kurt Angle. Of course, when we mean anybody can be chosen. Finn Balor can be chosen. Kenny Omega can be chosen. It doesn't matter. Bobby Roode, James Storm, Dean Ambrose, Baron Corbin, anybody can be chosen. And here we go, representing the Balor Club. Luke Gallows and Carl Anderson debuted. We caught up to Finn Balor after that little segment that happened, after that little distraction for the number one contenders match for the tag team champions. And Finn Balor had this to say. He said that Carl Anderson and Luke Gallows has been in Pure Wrestling since day one of season two. The reason why they never appeared is because they only come when I need them the most. That means when I'm outnumbered, when I'm losing, when I'm having a bad wrestling match, when somebody interferes and costs me my match, when I most need them, they are here. And Finn Balor, of course, stating the fact that whenever he calls them, they are coming. And he felt like now was the perfect time. Even though season one started a long time ago, he chose now to bring them up. And let's see what they can do. I mean, they just came, and now Finn Balor is looking to put some pressure on Kenny Omega, looking to defeat one of his henchmen, if you say, here tonight. As the bell rings, here we go, ladies and gentlemen, the start of this match, and Finn Balor already with the sling blade. We already know the history of Finn Balor and the Bullet Club going on here tonight. A big jawbreaker there. Oh, big knee breaker now. You have to assume that the Bullet Club sometimes take it a little too far. Of course, former Bullet Club members, a part of this war was AJ Styles. You had Adam Cole. Adam Cole was drafted to CJM, and AJ Styles, of course, drafted to CJM as well. Oh, big drop kick there, but it kind of missed. Oh, a big right hand. Oh, and now the strike's landing by Marty Scurll, and over the top he goes. Finn Balor now working on the leg. No, Marty Scurll working on the leg. Marty Scurll now, German suplex onto the outside, onto the floor. Man, that's gotta hurt. Oh, hold on, Finn Balor. Big shoulder tackle there. Balor able to withstand the strikes, the punches. I mean, he's faced tougher opponents before. Of course, Marty Scurll now leaving it up to the count out for him to get the victory. Of course, he would like to win that way. The villain always cheats to win. But here comes Balor. I don't know if I mentioned before, but no interference is allowed, even on Finn Balor's side. I mentioned about the Bullet Club side, but even Balor's side, they're not allowed to interfere into this match. Hold on now, body slam, no. Reverse into a death drop there. Into the cover now. One, no, and a kick out. Dragging him to the center now. Hold on. Into the ropes. Oh, what a big shining wizard by the Demon King himself, Finn Balor. Here we go now, Balor, springboard, oh, frog splash missed. That landing, he came crashing hard. Oh wait, hold on now, crossface chicken wing by Marty Scurll. Here we go. He's got it locked in. Finn Balor faded away to this move last week, but not today. I guess he has a little bit more strength to get out of it today than last week. Oh my God, the double knees to the gut. My goodness. Here comes Balor. Shoves him into the corner. Here we go, Finn Balor now. And running drop kick. Oh, got out of it. Marty Scurll, very technical right now. Marty Scurll now looks like a big power bomb. Oh, goodness. Go for the leg. If he won't get up top, do all those flashy moves that coup de grace can signal the end for the villain. Balor now picking him up. Oh, and a leg sweep caught him off guard there as Balor now. A big counter by Skull. Villain now. Hold on, Balor. Oh, Balor, what? Finn Balor, oh, he's taking a little too far now. Finn Balor now, hold on, wait a second. Oh my God. Taking it to the air, Finn Balor. Just diving on the villain. Skull has to be down after that. You can count to 100, no. The villain bouncing back right off of that maneuver. European uppercut, big kick. A reversal after reversal. These men know chain wrestling very well, I see. Here we go, oh my goodness. Watch out, his neck. Oh God, Balor getting the cover. Two and a kick out by Skull. Oh, going up top immediately. Finn Balor right away put so much pressure on the neck. Let's see what he's gonna do now. Oh, big missile drop kick. Landing right on its target. Oh, he's got him this time. No interference. He's right in place for what comes next. Oh, but Marty Skull just lifting up the leg. Oh my, he gets caught. Lifting up the leg. Big power bomb now. And this is how the villain tricks his opponent into thinking he's gonna pin them, but in actuality, it's a submission maneuver. Referee trying to find the best angle to see if Finn Balor's gonna tap, but he doesn't tap. Where is Marty Skull going? Maybe a little breather, I don't know what he's doing. Oh, a cover. But he wasted so much time that Finn Balor's gonna kick out. Come on, even I knew that, Skull, and I don't compete. Oh, a big kick. Well, I don't compete in the sense that I wrestle. I don't do that. Uh-oh, Marty Skull going up top. Finn Balor is down. This time, Marty Skull. This time, he's calling Balor up. Balor, watch out. Oh, big clothesline. Balor. Ooh. He's taking out that leg. Oh, throwing up the two sweet signs. Letting him know that he's all about the Balor Club, not the Bullet Club anymore. Here we go, picking him up yet again, and detonation kick. That kick to the temple, that's it. He's out of it. He's confused, he's dazed, he's on the floor. He's not getting up after this. Finn Balor getting a little bit of stamina, waiting for that perfect moment. Oh, but Marty Skull wanted to get out of it. Turns him around now. And just plants him right down on the mat. Finn Balor doing some extra damage that he doesn't need to do. Just go for the coup de grace. Come on, Balor. He just wants to punish the villain. And I think that's going to cost him at the end. And the end is going to cost him. Hold on. Finn Balor going up top now. Is this going to be it? Oh, here it comes. Coup de grace. Marty Skull, it's over. That's it. That's the last chapter for you. Your winner, Finn Balor, ladies and gentlemen, the Demon King, rising to the occasion. Finn Balor, the coup de grace was the last chapter of Marty Skull. Congratulations, Finn Balor, winning the main event of tonight. What an incredible sight to see. Finn Balor and Marty Skull main eventing Kenny Omega representing the Bullet Club, standing on top of the ramp. And as you see, Finn Balor telling him to bring it. Finn Balor, of course, would like to get some action in before the Great American Bash, but I don't think Kenny Omega is looking to do any of that. Kenny Omega mouthing the words, "I'll see you at the Great American Bash." Ladies and gentlemen, I would like to thank everybody for watching, sharing, subscribing. Follow me on Twitter down in the description below. Share this video. Don't forget, the Great American Bash is next week. And I would like to thank all my subscribers who've been here since day one. Thank you guys so much for being very supportive. You guys already know what I do. I'm glad I can make this content out for you guys each and every week if I make it. Thank you so much, and I'll see you guys for the Great American Bash.